Donald Trump landed in Georgia, Fulton County, and has already arrived to the jail where he had to turn himself in. Of course, this has to do with the indictment that he is facing in regard to his attempts to overturn the 2020 presidential election. Not a lot of details so far, other than the fact that if you go to the Fulton County, Georgia website, it'll shockingly list what his height and weight allegedly is. And it says that he is a white male with blonde or strawberry hair.
Yeah, that's what we're calling it now, strawberry, okay.
6'3 and 215 pounds.
No
that's
way.
That's what it says. I'm literally looking at the Fulton County, Georgia
fake
justice
news
website.
In this show, I predicted that they would put out his weight and Donald Trump would claim that it was fake news. Ironically, I'm now claiming it's fake news. There's no way that brother's 215 pounds. I don't know what in the world they're doing there, but that's crazy talk. But it is what it is. That's what they're reporting.
Trump also put out a message saying, "My last text to you before my arrest." It was a dramatic statement before booking at notoriously violent jail. He said the following: "Today, I will be going to the notoriously violent jail in Fulton County." By the way, the conditions in that jail are in fact deplorable and terrible, and that should change. There should be some serious reforms. Nonetheless, in Fulton County, Georgia, where I will be arrested despite having committed no crime. "Isn't it interesting that I went my entire life without ever getting arrested?" It is in fact interesting, definitely a nod to our two-tier justice system.
Can I just say, I wanna pause there for a second. It's exactly what we're talking about earlier in the show, where he, like, who would say, "Isn't it interesting that I never got arrested?" No, that's not interesting, that's normal, right? But he's accidentally telling on himself. He's like, "I committed all those crimes, never got arrested. All of a sudden they arrest me now as I'm running for president."
Yeah, but suddenly out of nowhere, once I decided to run for president as a political outsider and fight for the forgotten citizens of our country, I get arrested 4 times within the span of just 5 months. Not only that, a judge has ruled that today's spectacle may be televised for the entire world to see. The American people know what's going on. This is a punishment handed down from the deep state for daring to challenge the status quo by attempting to steal the presidential election. He didn't say that last part, I did. But daring to challenge the status quo and give a voice to the silent majority. The left wants to intimidate you out of voting. Isn't this breaking the conditions of his bond?
Of course he's gonna break it 1,000 times. They're like, "Don't talk about the witnesses." There's no way he's not gonna talk about the witnesses. Don't criticize the process, the judge, etc. Don't taint the jury pool by declaring that you're innocent 2,000 times over, etc. To be fair, I think he should be allowed to say he's innocent. To be fair,
I agree with you on that. I hate
the timing of these cases. So that 4 arrests in the last five months looks terrible. Like Manhattan DA, what were you doing all those years? That stuff drives me crazy. But Republicans, I know this is hard for you to hold in your head at the same time, but two thoughts can both be true, that the timing could be questionable and political, and he's still guilty. And it's still significant charges, like trying to steal an election. Like, you're super mad MAGA guys because you think Biden tried to steal the election. So you get how serious it is, right? So if they have evidence that Trump actually tried to steal the election, you could see why they would press charges. Wouldn't you press charges against Biden if you had the information that he stole the election?
I would want to press charges.
I would press charges against Biden. Yes. Yeah. Right.
Like, because look, I mean, I don't really see myself as a partisan anyway, right? I'm not obsessed with protecting the Democratic Party, which is why we're critical of the Democratic Party when they deserve to be criticized. However, at the same time, even if I was some Democratic ideologue and I was obsessed with the Democratic Party, you know what I'm more obsessed with? Our democratic process, our democracy, the ability for our voices to be heard at the ballot box, in the very least. The idea that I would favor a single politician more than that blows my mind. And yeah, that's what this is about, really.
And look, we've proven it 2,000 times over, but especially in the primaries, guys. If, let's say Biden, we had evidence that he tried to steal an election, I don't want him anywhere near the Oval Office. I would definitely vote against him, but not only that, it's a primary. Why don't you just pick another Democrat, right? So I don't, you don't have to vote for Ted Cruz or Donald Trump if you're a Democrat. I wouldn't. So that's what I'm saying in that hypothetical. But it's not a hypothetical for you guys on the Republican side. You have many other people to choose from. DeSantis is also a terrible guy. You could choose him. You'll love him, right?
Yeah.
So and on it goes. Why do you want to pick the guy who broke all these laws and try to undermine democracy?
Loyalty is to the country.
100%. Yeah. It's not even close. Look, there's one thing that Anna read you that is by far the most relevant fact out of all of this, and it's not his weight. It's that it's going to be televised. You're going to see one Republican after another come out and say he did it. Here's how he did it. Here's the evidence. You're going to see Georgia Republican after Georgia Republican. These are Southern, massively right-wing conservative Republicans. And if we see that televised, that makes an enormous difference. That's one of the very, very few ways that Trump could lose the primary.
And below his statement, he also provided a link that gives his supporters the opportunity to donate up to $3,300 to the Trump Save America Joint Fundraising Committee.
Of course. Yeah. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.